Yes, Jen, well, right now the scene is very quiet here in Gilford. However, up until about 15 minutes ago, it was a very active scene. The State Police Major Crime Unit was parked right here in the driveway, and there was crime scene tape right around the building while investigators tried to work and figure out how this all played out.
State Police investigators walked in and out of the house at 123 Country Club Road on Thursday. Some could be seen through windows in the basement. Investigators were back 4 days after Roberta Miller's body was found by a relative. The 54-year-old's death caused by gunshot wounds and now ruled a homicide. Miller lived in the Gilford home alone. Recently divorced, her court battle still continued. In September, the court ordered Ms. Miller to pay more than $74,000 within 15 days for her share of income tax liability. But Ms. Miller had yet to comply, saying she didn't have the money. 5 days before her death, an attorney for Miller's ex-husband filed paperwork at Carroll County Superior Court asking that she be held in contempt for not paying. Her ex-husband's lawyer suggested Ms. Miller squandered close to $1 million in cash during the course of the divorce or simply didn't want to pay. The week before her death, court documents show that Ms. Miller turned the Gilford home and another in Wolfboro over to a trust. Another home in Acton, Maine, that went to her husband in the divorce was burned to the ground 3 days before her body was found. The Maine Fire Marshal's office says the fire was arson and they are investigating. As for Ms. Miller's death, investigators haven't commented on a motive or any suspects.
Now, inside Ms. Miller's house, they also found her dog, who had also been shot and killed. Reporting live in Gilford, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.